So the first thing I do with any sketch is to grab a pencil and scribble out a few lines to get a rough idea of where things will go. Now this one took a fair amount of thought, far more than sorts of sketches I typically do. This is perhaps one of the reasons why I've been putting off sketching this for so long. I've been wanting to sketch this scene for ages, but I just always thought it looked far too complicated. But I finally decided to commit to it. I'm going to have a go and see if I can nail it. The good thing about doing a pencil sketch first is it gives you a good idea of where things are going to go, make sure everything's going to fit on the page and where the objects are going to be placed in the scene. So you can rub it out if you get it wrong, you can change your mind, you can ignore what you've done in pencil and do something completely different once you get to the ink stage that comes next. That's the purpose of the pencil sketch, and you can take as long as you like or you can do it really quickly and scribbly. I took about 4 or 5 minutes to scribble this out. And if you're watching this because you were looking for Harry Potter videos and you came across this and you never even heard verbin sketching, why not download the photo and have a go? You don't need any training. No one's ever taught me how to sketch. I just picked up a pen and started drawing, taught myself. The point of this video and the point of this channel is to get people sketching and get people inspired in doing art without overthinking it or worrying about what other people think. So why not give it a go? And I'm almost ready to move on to the next stage. I just feel like that's enough. I don't have to go into a massive amount of detail. Albeit I do often draw too much, turn it into a proper drawing, but I think that's pretty much all that needs to be done. And then I can move on to the ink drawing stage. Because I'm going to be using watercolour, I want to be using a permanent waterproof ink for this stage so that I can paint over the lines with watercolour and they will show through and they won't smudge or run. And so I'm using a Uni Pin 0.6mm fineliner pen. For that, I've tried lots of different fineliner pens and this is one of my favourites and one of my favourite sizes. A lot of sketchers use a thinner size, 0.1, 0.2mm pen, something like that, but I like a slightly chunkier line. It just suits my sketching style. And so my first task with the ink drawing stage was to draw the sweeping curve of the bridge that would be in front of the train, and then it was to draw the train itself up to the point where the steam would cross over it, and then I had to go back in and fill in the rest of the bridge and the train in behind. This took an awful lot of working out, and it was actually one of the reasons why I've been putting off sketching this for so long. I wasn't entirely sure if I was actually going to be able to work it out, but I did, and that's really one of the lessons I took from this, is that it doesn't matter how complicated a scene looks. As long as you just study it and look at what's there, you can just roughly follow it. It doesn't matter if it's entirely accurate, it doesn't matter if it's perfect, it doesn't matter if it's wonky as anything, and my drawings certainly are wonky, although this is probably one of the least wonky sketches I've ever done. I was quite happy at this stage that I'd got the train roughly how I wanted it, and the good thing is the more and more detail I added onto the train, the more it started to look like an actual train and not just some weird jumble of lines. So now I'm drawing in a bit more detail on the train itself. So there's windows going in, and then on the top of the train there's lots of dotty bits which you can't really see in the small picture, but if you download the full size photograph from the link then you'll be able to see all those sorts of details. And then I went back in and packed in even more detail onto the train. So now I started drawing in all the bricks. And this is one of those sketches where you start drawing bricks and you think, oh, I wish I'd never started drawing bricks, because there are about 3.7 million of them. There are an awful lot of bricks to draw and it's an enormous job, but I think it was worth it because it gives the bridge a solidity. I had decided for this sketch that I was not going to paint the bridge in watercolour, I was only going to paint the train itself because I wanted the train to stand out. And if anyone saw my previous sketching demo, which was of an Art Deco cinema in America, my conclusion from drawing that one was that I used far too much watercolour, and so I wanted to try going much more minimalist, because when I do marker pen sketches, which are my main type of sketching, I do leave a lot more white space on the page. But for some reason, when I do watercolour, I seem to get carried away and end up covering every inch of paper in paint. So I wanted to take a different approach for this. The train will be painted and the rest of it will be left just as an ink drawing. Because this is in Scotland, where I'm from, I drove past here once when I was coming back from the Isle of Skye, and so I was going to stop in, take the obligatory photograph that every tourist on planet Earth seems to have taken, and oh my goodness, there were so many people, so many tourists, that I just thought, I'm not going to get anywhere near there, so I gave up and drove home. But if you'd Google Glenfinnan Viaduct, you will see an awful lot of pictures of this place with the steam train running across, and that's all thanks to Harry Potter. He has got a lot to answer for. So once I've finished packing in all of that detail and I'm quite happy with the ink drawing, I go over it with a Faber-Castell putty eraser. This is a very squishy eraser that artists use because it doesn't damage the paper. And once that's done, I'm ready to start colouring in with watercolour. The paints I'm using are Royal Talens Van Gogh watercolours. And I started off with a red and a blue, just little touches on the front. And I'm using a size 6 paintbrush. It's got a nice pointy tip, and that's just the brush that came with the paint set. The only other paintbrush I have is a flat brush that came with a beginner's art set, so it just proves that you don't need lots of expensive equipment, lots of expensive paintbrushes. The most basic brushes will do, especially for something like urban sketching, because it's a lot more relaxed, a lot more loose than maybe if you're trying to become a fine art painter, where you perhaps need a lot more fancy equipment. One of the beauties of urban sketching is you can use the most basic equipment and you just crack on with creating art and being creative, having fun, and not worrying about the end result. So for the train itself, I painted that in a dusk pink that comes in this set. It's a really nice dark maroon colour. And then for the steam engine part of the train, albeit the train is black, I decided to paint indigo, which is a really dark blue, because I wanted the ink drawing lines to come through slightly. And if you go pure black, it'll be harder to see the lines. For the roofs of the carriages, I used a Payne's Grey, which is a bluish grey shade. And as I said, I'm not going to paint any of the brickwork or anything else in the sketch. So all I really needed to do to finish up was to turn the lights on in the carriages, and that was me done. So there you go, that is the Harry Potter Glenfinnan Viaduct in Scotland, and I'm sure little Harry himself would be proud. You can just imagine him sitting there in the little carriages, looking out forlornly, going, off I go to Hogwarts once again, back to fight with that man with no nose. If you enjoyed this video, please do check out the rest of the Urban Sketchy channel for lots more sketching inspiration, and you can also head over to my website, urbansketchy.com, for more of my sketches and other sketchy goodness. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in the next Urban Sketchy video.